Welcome to a world where ChatGPT, Bard, Midjourney, and a ton of other LLMs can write poetry, generate art, and understand your deepest thought. Welcome to the future.
LLM is a very complicated concept, but understanding it is the key to unlocking its full potential. So where can we find a person who talks deeply about LLMs, how they work, and how to get the most out of them? Hi, if you want to understand LLMs, keep watching this video because I'm gonna make it easy for you.
LLM stands for Large Language Model, which is a recent innovation in AI and machine learning. Briefly, it means that the model is fit with a very large set of texts and learns to use them. The computer analyzes all sorts of books, articles, papers, and whatnot, and learns to use them. Large language models are a type of neural network-based model. That means the learning procedure for the model is inspired by the human brain. You see, the brain is billions of brain cells or neurons connected to each other. When one neuron receives an input, that information goes through a network and output is produced. We might not know exactly what happens in the network, but the network can keep making, clothing, strengthening, or weakening connections until it produces the right response. A large language model learns like a neural network. Think about a simple network. There's an input, a layer of neurons, and an output. We'll get into it, don't worry about it. Let's start with the inputs. LLMs use digits instead of letter. Each letter or word or character is represented by a digit we call tokens. And inputs and output for the model are processed through these tokens. Now in a neural network, this input gets passed onto neural layer. This is where the magic happens. The number of layers, the importance each layer has for us, and how these layers connect and interact determine the output. All the features that are used to determine the output are called parameters. Remember, we told you that the human brain makes and breaks connection until it gets the right response. In the same manner, we can't change the value of the hidden layer of an artificial neural network in order to get the different outputs. The number of values we can change equals the number of parameters we have. The word large in large language models also refers to the number of parameters we have. ChatGPT, for instance, uses about 175 billion parameters. The more parameters we have, the more modification we can make to the hidden layers to produce our desired outcome. The better these parameters are tuned, the more accurate the model gets at understanding what we mean and producing correct response. So parameters determine how neural network processes input data and produces output data. We now understand what LLM means, what neural network means, and how LLMs use neural network to function. This is how LLM works, but how does LLM, like a ChatGPT, learn with all that information? Scientifically, there are four steps through which the LLM training process takes place. First is actually data collection, which can be derived from multiple sources like books, articles, website, content, or open data sets. Then comes model configuration, which refers to the number of layers or some other settings that determine how fast the model learns. And then comes the next step, which is the most important one, is actually model training. Basically, all LLMs use deep learning techniques and self-supervised learning for training. In the process of self-supervised learning for large language model, the model is given large data sets and is asked with learning to predict the next word or tokens in the sequence. The process is repeated billions of times until the model is able to learn the statistical relationship between words and phrases. In other words, it can understand which word or character should come after the current one. And last is fine-tuning. The model is tested to see how well it does. If needed, it's fine-tuning by tweaking the setting or adding some more data in order to improve its performance. All right, once an LLM is ready to fire, it can perform a variety of natural language processing tasks, including generation and transformation. In generation, you can expect the model to produce original content. For instance, a poem that you've never heard before for your new love, or an essay about how crushable you are. In transformation, instead of creating new content, the model changes the content that you've already provided to something else. For instance, paraphrasing a text, changing it from formal to informal, or analyzing it or translating it. Now let's say you ask LLM like ChatGPT how to cook a Spanish omelet, right? The LLM takes your question as an input and processes it in a fraction of time, and then it responds to you based on the large data set that GPT or LLM has been trained on before. But sometimes you might not get the response you expected, and the solution is to proceed the conversation by clarifying what you want. This could be an example or sample of the kind of response you expect, and you will probably get you what you were looking for. But what happened and how? This is because the neural network is also powered by memory. LLMs can memorize your conversation and analyze it to understand what you are trying to get. Any text that you, the user, feed into an LLM as an input is called prompt. Simply prompt refers to any kind of sentence, word, or character that you write as an input that will trigger the LLM to respond. Well, I will make a very comprehensive video about it in the near future, and I'll introduce some websites for learning prompting. For now, let's see how we can assess an LLM's capability. Let's start at the end of November 2022, when OpenAI released an LLM called ChatGPT. I think that's when most people heard the word of LLM for the first time. ChatGPT surprisingly hit 100 million users in just 2 months, and I think this is the fastest growing app in history. And after that, tons of businesses and services came out that were powered by OpenAI's API. We thought that we were witnessing a new cutting edge tool revolutionize the world single-handedly, but Google released something similar to ChatGPT right after that, which is called Bard. But is that where the story ends? Nope. Many LLMs like ChatGPT have emerged so far, including GPT-4, GPT-3 from OpenAI, Palm 2 from Google, or Llama from Meta, and many more. But which ones are the most capable? To effectively assess a large language model, there are 5 key criteria to consider. Number 1 is actually parameters. The number of parameters is one of the most important factors that determine the capabilities of an LLM. Model with more parameter can learn more complex pattern in a data and generate creative and informative text. Number 2, character limitation. There is a cap on how many character an input and output can have. Some model might not be able to process unlimited number of text as an input. Number 3 is model memory. Like I said, some model have memory in their network model. If a model can accurately memorize your conversation, it's gonna be better at producing the result you expect and is therefore considered a good model. Number 4, response accuracy. Well, it's somehow difficult to be sure whether the information you are getting is true or not. I think in some cases you might need to have strong knowledge base already to understand whether the information presented to you is correct or not. So the higher the proven accuracy, the better. On the other hand, there are some problems and disadvantages that keep recurring. However, these problems are being solved. For example, sometimes you might have seen in LLM GPT-4 or GPT-3, references are mostly incorrect because an LLM produces its response by gathering little bits and pieces of information from huge set of sources. Each sentence or even word may have come from different sources that makes it simply impossible to cite. Number 2, subconscious bias. Remember that LLMs are trained by the information that they are fed. What if the information is biased? The LLMs become biased, and this means LLMs can stereotype, act too conservatively, or even be sexist. Number 3, hallucination. It's difficult to get an LLM to just admit it doesn't know the answer to your question. Instead, LLM will make up answer it hallucinates. Number 4, math. In some cases, even model 3 or 4 of GPT, it's been seen that it doesn't solve mathematical question correctly. It's because the number of trained math question is way lower than general subjects. Why am I highlighting these weaknesses of LLMs? To emphasize 2 things. Number 1, well, I do believe that they are not fully capable of taking over all jobs based on the text that they receive as an input, at least not yet. So I don't think they're gonna take over jobs like a copywriting or data analyst, because again, they cannot cover all soft skills. And number 2 is actually, all LLMs need a skill to be directed by prompt in order to get the best possible answer. If you want to like learn prompting, like I said, in the middle, prompting is very important. All you have to do is just open up learnprompting.org. I put the link in the description below. And in the menu, just click under Learn. Then you're gonna be led to a page that teaching you all the prompts in different usages for LLMs. You can like learn how to prompt for each your needs, like how to write an article. You need some prompts. check out the website and let me know if you have a question in the comment section below. All right, that's all for now. If you enjoyed this video, just hit the thumbs up button and turn on notification, and you won't miss any of our new videos. Peace.